on the way to the studio right now, so I might vlog a little and give you guys a little snippet of my song. I'm excited, and yeah, see you guys when I'm at the studio.
Recording a video, or are you going live?
It's a video. I have to edit it.
See, that's what I'm talking about. That's that perfection stuff.
No, but like you have to edit videos when you're on YouTube.
That's what I'm saying. YouTube is cool. You can go live. But...
I guess.
It's like I hear it in one side of the headphones. Okay. That sounds pretty good.
I admit it, shoulda never did it. Now we are here in your driveway, 2 a.m. became a habit.
Do I need to be louder? Let me do it like, I admit it, shoulda never did it. Then, okay, yeah.
Now we are here in your driveway, 2
a.m. Okay, when it's all come together, you can be like, wow.
Shawty, I need to know if you're down to ride. Tell me that you're the one that's by my side. Through all the ups and downs, the lows, the highs.
Do you hear that in my throat? I have a big frog in my throat.
Through all the... What is going on? Think about it, be about it, baby, let me know. Read about it, everything exposed.
Yeah. Okay. Write songs all the time, though. So sometimes it is hard for me to remember lyrics, but these I remember.
Cause you got it. Hey. Tell you all the things I think.
See, when I do that type of stuff, I imagine myself in my concerts. Sometimes though with that, you get too carried away while you're singing. Are you rapping at that point?
Hey.
I just want to spin a trap. There's hella people in here.
Oh, fuck.
I have arrived. Why are you running? Why are you running?
Why are you running? Why are you running?
You know, it's like every time I come home, like to my hometown, I always notice like such a striking difference between my hometown and Atlanta. Like obviously Atlanta is like a city, like a big city, but I mean as far as like my households, I think sometimes like parents, they think that giving your kid materialistic things will make up for the fact that you don't give them enough love, you don't show them enough attention and emotion. And my dad has like he has a pretty big house. It's a nice size house, but you know, I feel like he thinks that is enough. You know what I mean? Like if I provide her with a nice house, I was sleeping in the basement on an air mattress for like a whole year, the whole time I was there. So I never felt the love, if that makes sense. But when I come back home to my mom, our house is, you know, regular size, and she's always showed me love, an amount of support, even when she didn't have materialistic things to give me, or she worked her butt off to give me these materialistic things. So I don't know, I guess the older I get, the more I realize certain things like that. Like, I kind of was a brat when I was a teenager, and growing up, it kind of made me more grateful for it. And when I come home, it gives me like I have a sense of purpose. Like, you know, I feel grounded. I don't know if it's because it's smaller, or maybe I'm more comfortable here, or I feel like I can be myself here. Whereas in Atlanta, there's so many different personalities, you know what I mean? And I don't know what I'm talking about, but I'm here at Walmart, y'all. If y'all would like a full story time, or maybe like a podcast. I really like talking about deep things.